kingdom that each of us bring. This is the Whenuaku in which we live and the one that we need to claim. This is the one we're sovereigns of. And once we claim that, then we receive this money. Yeah, and of course we've got... What colour is that? Or is that red? Yeah. And of course we've got the power outfit of weapons, etc. The bombs, etc. Destroying the people, the land, all our water. Plants, the fish, the waters, everything that we are. So we're saying these things are not acceptable. They're all weapons of mass deception and destruction. And we're all following like whatever. And we've got a massive suicide rate. Our young people are crying out. We're saying this is what we need to stop. The other thing is the banks, they have taken control. Rothschild set them up way back, and this was his thinking. Give me control of the nation's currency, and I care not who makes the law. That's exactly how they're running today. At the bottom there, that's us, all living things. The government controls us, their laws, education, health, employment, everything. Above them sits the corporations, who get special loans, etc., that the rest of us don't get. Above them sit the bigger banks, the national banks, the International Monetary Fund, which is the United Nations. All of these are all controlled by them. And at the top, you have got 1% of the world's population who are creaming. Is that good enough? No. Okay, Henry Ford, he said, it is well enough that the mass of people do not understand our banking system, or if they did, there would be a revolution by morning. And that's the reality. That right-hand one shows us at the bottom going up and getting a loan. They've got no money. They get a piece of paper. They write on it, yes, and now you spend the rest of your life, it's your credit you went there with, they took your signature, and you spend the rest of your life paying for having given them your signature. It was yours. We own it. We are the banks. We need to be aware of that. So, do we want to get rid of the banking system? Yes. All the interest goes back to those top dogs. And look at the size of how much they bring. And that's living in a debt system, which came in the 1930s, when these governments were bankrupt. And so to sort that bankruptcy, they transferred the debt to every one of us. Is it yours? It's not. So why don't we wipe it out? Who says we can't? Okay, next one. Oh, and here is how they set up their corporation. Same thing, top dog down. In the centre there is the Queen. It's a corporate, and New Zealand is a corporate state. And you've got the Treaty of Waitangi is equal with the Queen. Well, hello, the Whakaputanga is for that, and so is the Rangatira. not from out there. It comes from within. This is where, if you look into the visible, you'll find the invisible. If you look in, you're also being tutored all the time. Their education system, far inferior to what you're being given. But you need that too. The individual is in their wholeness. It's not divided from them. They're always one. And everything is integral. Everything is connected. Okay. So still into four. Did you want to go on?
Takumio ia pāna ki te tangi mai o I rāo ko o. Horakau tēnei e mea na hau he ture. Engari e tuku atu nau ko māke ke taito i rongo au I ngā ngātarangi. I roto I te ngāhere me o rātau whakapāo I ēnei mono tangi ne. Tō rātau kōrero mai ki ahau e pāna ki I rāo ko o. Ko te wahine anake e mōi ana o tēhea wāma o te whakamamai o tōna tinana o te whakaputanga mai o te mōpna. Nā, mena e te roto koe te mamai o te pārau tamariki. E noho ana koe, e mōi ana koe e kiki mai ana te tinana. Ta rongo koe ia koe anu e, aio, aio. Koe mei tō rātou ako mai ia hau. Ena, tangi e rua e pāna mo te whakaputa. Horai kau e I rongo au kare au I rongo ia rātou e nāna ako te supreme aharaine. Engari mo te mamai o te wahine I roto I tana ao whakaputa I ngā mokopuna e hare mai. Nā, koina tāku e hie I ana ki te tuku I te wānanga nei, hei whakaarohia mō tāka. Hei whakaarohia.
And this is where our wanatiratanga comes from. It's our inherent sovereignty. Another one of the hidden crap. Our sovereignty is inherent. It is not out there in a political system or given to us by any man. And that's why we can claim the way we do.
Yeah.
And why we should claim the way we do. In step four, this is what's happening. Seeds are being sown. Thinking, well, hopefully, it's coming from someone else and not from this tiny little brain that I've got.
Whānaki ki tēnei nā, taku rongonga mai I taku au tamariki, e ako mai ana ngā tarangi mo te wai. Te wai e takotou nei te kākano, ne? Taua mo te wai. Ko te wai tēnā, e hakahora ana I te mokopuna, nā te mea, I roto I taua wai. Horakau ia mōhi ana ki te kino, horakau ia mōhi ana ki te whakakore te āraha, horakau ia ia e nā momo. Kei roto I te wai, ngā mōhi o tana katoa e pāna ki te ngā ture atu. Ngā ture e hāna ana, kaha ki mōhi maha. Nā, te putanga mai, we learn how to be ugly, we learn how to be dishonest, greedy, and yet while we're in there, we're pure, we're beautiful. Mm-hmm. So they used to always say to me, go back into the womb. Anytime you need to, just go back into the womb, into that water mass, where everything was clean and pure. And so the reason for that to be there is to allow us to go, oh, true. Mm-hmm. That's true. You know, we didn't know how to be naughty and mean and all those things, but we come out and learn it. So when you want to clean ourselves, go inside. Go back and have a sleep. koine ngā turituri I vangia mai ngā, ngā kāhi o te ki, te one tū o oponone, ka tai ka wāwā I hia te kupuke pēra te hanga mai I runga te ki o oponone. Nā, ka rātau he ria, ke tāukiro to iau, ke kore tātou e ware ware, ko tātou ngā tamariki o wai. Ko tātou ngā tamariki o wai, o rā. Ko wai ia. Ko tātou ngā ngā uri. Tātou ngā tamariki o rā. Ko otike te tīti mai me, a haripa I roto te pare kairo, tīti mai e ngā kai kairo, I ngā pau ngā harai ne. It's already etched in us that we are the children of that atua, of that tupuna. Collectively, we are. And collectively, we are the essence of that. Now, sorry to interrupt.
And the now, today, it's all about getting the numbers together. Well, one with truth is a majority. All other numbers come down from one, so the Ngā is the all-inclusive. Today, with politics, etc., it's the number of votes you get, so that takes you in there. It doesn't alter the fact that the truth is with every one of us. It's not in the numbers game that they play out through. So, the objective is to pull ourselves back together, to become whole in ourselves. Yes. Out there in their scriptures or whatever, they talk about coming into atonement. It is actually at oneness. It's not about punishment. It's about at oneness. Becoming one, having one. Not becoming one, you already are, but recognizing that. And our money is simply kaitia, can't touch. Not ownership, and we have to get past that ourselves. We've fallen into this is ours and that's ours and so on and so on and so on. But we'll reproduce exactly what we've got if we stay in that way of thinking. We need to honour kaitia, can't touch. And teach them that this is what it's about, not ownership. And that's going to be important because if we take away their money and take away their system, well, now what they're going to do? Now they're going to have to look after one another. No matter whether we're green, black, blue, whatever. And so, in 1835, that Puhi out the declaration.
Later on, when we share what we've achieved using the mana of this beautiful poem that was meant to go back to and escape from ourselves. So what some of the education that they read in the particularly from 1957 onwards was how to take care of a particular letter that our people received in 1858 from Queen Victoria via her today, who was Colonel Thomas Ball Brown. Now, Colonel Thomas Ball Brown prepared this letter, put it, her insignias inside all the pages, so when you lift the original up, you can see her watermark, you can see the names of the Pākehā men who wrote the Māori text in that letter. Their names are Cashdown, Williams, Montour, Spine, Kent, one more, I can't remember. What was that fella?
Bacon, what's the other one?
Hutton, yeah, oh, that's right, that's where I lived in this Pākehā village. In Auckland, they had one of the families there, the Huttons. And I went over and I said, this is your tūpapa. Oh, he was a very careful person. And so this letter, they said, is the only evidence us Mokopuna would need to be able to have this whenua returned to us again. When it is time to use it, they'll come back, wake my brain up, and it would be when I was in my 50s, 60s, and don't look who's going to help us. They'll bring them to the door and answer the letter back to that state lady, depending on what I call. Taki tēnā wā, me mō. Tukuna tu e re, taki te wahine rā, te kui ni rā. Lea te pēke I o wana pēke, e o ki te kai. Koina tu āta, tōmu tōmu, mai ki nei tō wane, the 1858 letter. In that 1858 letter was the only evidence that we would collectively be able to stand with. Say to the Queen, you need to go home. This is our proof. You send us a letter. You put all your laws of England into this letter. There's a working copy of it. Have a look at the laws, she says in her letter. Have a look at the laws of England. I've even put them into Maori for you, in case you wouldn't be able to read English. And could you have a look and give me a call if you'd like to in your name? Basically is what that letter says. So the old people taught me how to hear. They would narrate it to me. In E ngā rangatira, me ngā kaiwhaka haere tika, me ngā tangata Māori kato puta no e te motu nei, tēnā rā koutou whakaroro mai. I mua, I ka pīte nei whenua edu me te kino e te pauri e. Ai, there we go. Ai. And so that's how I got taught that tika. It's in me, I'll never forget. And the very first sentence in that letter to our Pūpuna is the only evidence we need. What does it say? Ki aku hoa. That's how it starts. Ki aku hoa. E ngā rangatira. Me ngā kaiwhakahaere tikanga. Me ngā tangata Māori katoa puta noi te motu nei. Tēnā rā koutou whakarongo mai. So what they ensured that I would never forget was who it was addressed to. It was addressed to who?
The rangatira.
Who? Who did he address that letter to? The rangatira. On her behalf, Queen Victoria's behalf. What else is it addressed to? It's approaching the law fraternity of the rangatira. What does it say? E ngā rangatira, me ngā kai whakahaere tika. So the Aotearoa understood in 1858, if they were approaching the law fraternity of the rangatira, or ngā kai whakahaere tika, that tells you now straight away what the law was that was being practiced in our land. In 1858. It certainly wasn't a British law that they told you and I happened in 1840. Please, do I look like I just sent on eggs? 1835, where rangatira, 1840, are you full of sadness? were bought the lie. So what I got taught by the Premis is their treaty of Waitangi didn't happen. Stop it. It didn't happen. It's called Te Kawenapa, Uruma Whenua. Look inside your passports. What does it say? Uruma Whenua. It doesn't say Te Treaty of Waitangi. It says Uruma Whenua. The document our kupuna saw up in Waima was called Te Kawenapa, Uruma Whenua. The covenant of entry into our lands. It's an immigration document. Stop buying their eye. Stop it. We're dishonouring our kupuna. We're letting them sell us a lie. Kawenapa, Uruma Whenua, an immigration document is what they use to steal our whenua. But they stop using their letter to take it back. So easy. And with that mahi that tūpuna gave us to do, they said to me, look after it. Look after it, moho. When it's time to answer it, when you answer it, and my sister stepped up to the plate, her crazy sister, and helped to send that notice to quit. It is called notice to quit all Crown business in our lands. And rejection absolute of the laws of 1858. Rejection absolute. Do you think we meant it? Hell yeah. That rejection absolute. From the waka on our Mokopuna here out there. Now I'll be straight up. I keep putting up there. The Whakaminenga on our. And I turn around and it's Waipo and the waka on our Mokopuna here out there. So I yell out, okay, who's playing with my computer? You know, the other workers. Haven't been near it by itself. What? Wipe that out, put that. Because now I'm a functional piece. And it kept being changed on me. So I thought, okay, I'm not going to hold tight to it again. The Whakaminenga on Hapu need to be. And I went like this and I watched. And then I saw the change. No. Tūpuna wanted us to send the rejection absolute back on a letterhead, that if you decide to put on your korowai of a mokopuna, you instantly own having sent her a notice to quit your land. You put your mokopuna korowai up, you can take ownership of sending the queen rejection absolute as a mokopuna. That's why they changed it on us. That's not something I wanted to do. That was given. And were we big enough? Look, we haven't got to the juicy bit, but the timekeeper's standing there and I'm really uncomfortable. What do you fucking want to do? You want me to sit down? Stop? And what would you like? I'm open. Okay. Right. So that happened, and then my sister thought, oh my God, can I really sign that? And so at least she did. But all the ones that helped us propose it, who were down there with me, Dan Davis, all the ones from the Whakaminenga in Auckland, your part and parcel, Calvin Alps, who was the beautiful Kaumatua, they all helped us collect the information in that. And then asked my sister and I, since we've been the kaitiaki of that letter, which allowed us now to get our whenua back without a fight. That's what the people said. No gun to be fired, no bullet to be fired, or life to be lost. It's got to be done in a peaceful way. So they asked her and I to take ownership of signing the rejection did that. 9 days later, we got a reply back from the Queen, which was pretty quick, because we sent her a notarized copy of the 1858 letter, sealed with by a lawyer and all that stuff. So she knew what this was in rejection to. Yeah, the authorized copies. So when she received that, notice to quit, with that reject, the notarized copies, she knew what it was we were answering to. And that, no, we don't want your laws in our land. Gee, thanks for no thanks. And she wrote back, acknowledged that, told us to go see her representative to remedy the problem, which was Sylvia Cartwright at the time. Yeah, I think it was Sylvia Cartwright. To take our appeal to her. And then we, she sent everything the Queen sent her back in a courier bag. So it's never been opened. It's there for our opponents and our interviews to see how they dealt with the problem. And then 2004.
Before you switch, can you switch that back? Can you read that letter to us, please?
The rejection.
Oh, I can't see it.
Very good.
Which
yeah,
one?
I can't see
very
it.
Very
Queen's letter.
Oh, rejection.
Can someone read it, please? I can't see it.
The one from the Queen or the rejection absolute?
No, the one from the Queen.
Okay.
Oh.
Have you got a clear copy of it? No. Glasses?
I'll give you one there.
No, that's a double zoom.
For us, it isn't so much what she says, it's the fact she got our, from our relatives, that is, she got our message. We told her that we do not accept your laws, and she has received that. What she thinks about it, what says about it, is really irrelevant.
Yeah.
Oh, no, it is relevant.
Dear Mr. King, the Queen has asked me to thank you for your letter and enclosures of the 9th of November. And to say that Her Majesty has taken careful note of the views you express in it. Perhaps I might explain, however, that this is not a matter in which the Queen would intervene. As a constitutional sovereign, Her Majesty acts through her personal representative, the Governor General, on the advice of the New Zealand ministers, and it is to them that your appeal should be directed. I have therefore been instructed to forward your letter to the Governor General of New Zealand so that she may be aware of your approach to the Queen and may consider the point you raise. Yours sincerely, Mrs. Deborah B. B. And so that was the reply 9 days later.
Yet what are our people doing about it? We have a choice because it's a breach of trust, it's a breach of contract, and especially in the time when Queen Victoria in the 1860s sent her military here to basically invade our people, kill our people, and the raupatis have stolen all our lands. Okay, the Crown of England have been in breach of that Te Tiriti o Waitangi for the last 166 years. And that is a stamped letter. I have got letters like that as well, and it's the same cordial, same reply. They sent it to this Governor General.
If
Well,
I'm allowed
I've actually served two
can we just
official documents on the Governor General myself,
mention
and what do they do? They don't even reply.
so
So
that
we
so
have a
that would
solution.
show you the remedy that we have put into place, because we can't talk of what
Yeah,
you're
but
saying,
the
you
recourse, there's
know,
no recourse on
boundaries.
of what I'm saying. We have
If
got a
we're allowed to
solution,
continue, or
and
should you
we
take over?
Time is going.
Okay.
We've already gone out of time with this one. What I'd like to do is to, we'll have Lynn do a kōrero about this later on. Aroha mai, kei te haere te wā, and we have three more kaupapa we need to get through.
Okay, I can do the last bit now in 10 minutes. Bang, I do. Just so that we have an end to the story.
Koe tatu takai te mana o tēnei marae. Me hanga mō tatu. Koe tatu takai te mana o ngai winei no ta tēnei o tō rātou marae.
Nā kute he, nena mena koe nā kute he aroha mai. We'll pack up, we get the message.
Tāua, kia tau te rangi Māori.
Ai,
kia tau te rangi
Māori. Tau mai hana i dungu te rangi mai.
Kia tau te rangi Māori, ma iwe me o ngā mahi i te rangi Māori.
Ai.
He wāhanga i ko atu mō ētahi o ina. Ko he pāke i tā koutou. Tēnā ka tāia koe te whakamutu o kōrero. Tēnei wā tōmu nei, ka tāia, ka tau te whakahaere, ka tau te tua. He mua mai o te kai o te rangi. I'll ask them to extend the lunch a little bit later so we can get the next kaupapa.
Kia ora tēnā.
Hai?
Koe nā kia mātou.
Kia te rangi Māori.
Kau te rangi.
He sent a reply back to the Queen to remind her that she didn't accept this. Could she reply to that again? And then, in it we made it clear it was not an appeal, so we went to the Governor General, the Māori fellow at this time, and he directed us to John Peel. So through the Queen's directive in her correspondence as evidence for us, and the Governor General, we ended up down at John Peel's office. And we have evidence of having our contacts with them were successful. And we went there with a specific purpose to now implement what we had said to the Queen was going to happen. We're not here to justify what we did, but we were happy at what we did. And we understand that people find it difficult to follow the track that we've gone down. But what we did was we took the evidence, went there, served a cease and desist notice on a John Key, and within our culture, we have our law within our culture. When you do a take and your take is placed, whether it's understood, accepted, or whatever, it's a take, it's in place. We are people of our word, and so we don't have to wait for a reply or all those kind of things. They're not necessary. But what we have seen by the mahi that we've been involved in is that we can evidence for you the success of having placed these trusts of our people now into the places that we are being directed to place. When 23 these stations were announced the other day, they had to be closed because they were no longer being by sworn allegiance, please. 23 got shot. That was due to the mahi group, though we can evidence that. Then the SIFS makes an announcement that they are no longer to be named the SIFS or vulnerable children, whatever, but from that day forward they would be known as a Ministry of Waka Ora Matamari. We can evidence to you how that happened because of the work we've done. When the Corrections Department announced that the release of 23 prisoners the other day because they had been called out due to the work that was produced, that they were holding our people incorrectly. And so these are just some examples of the things that we have achieved and what we use to achieve it. And we're not saying this is the only way to go forward. This is our presentation of how we've gone forward. And if it excites you, if it's something you'd like your mokopuna to inherit, please don't hesitate to come. Pick up the oar on the waka that belongs to you. Because they said, moko, go out. When you've answered that letter, take the original out. Show our mokopuna what we save for their future. Give them our love. And so I did that. Couldn't matter about whatever treatment. But I did what Tupuna asked. And so, what we have ready for release, and we would love you all to stand with it, is a proclamation. Whether you support it or not, irrelevant, it's going to be released because the Tupuna planned us to release it. But it would be fabulous if the Whakaminenga o our Hapu representative whānau stood with the proclamation that's going to go out. This is not our money, as I said, it's just going to happen. So what I would like to do is, if I do the proclamation, a little bit of it, we can evidence everything that is inside that proclamation because it's built on truth. We've done nothing but we haven't tried to be famous for us. We've only listened to the teachings of our ancient ones and put it down in truth. And that's why we've succeeded. Not because we need, but because it's true. Now they pull off the paper, it'll set us free. It'll set us free. So this is part of the proclamation that we have. Further to previous correspondence with and on the directive of Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, and latterly her representative, the Governor General of New Zealand. Te waka o ngā mōpuna ki Aotearoa representing the Rangatira peoples of New Zealand, known collectively as the Whakaminenga o ngā Hapu o Ngutiri. As per our nation's irrevocable founding document and constitution, proclamation of sovereignty, he Whakaputanga o te Rangatira tanga o Ngutiri in 1835, we herewith instruct Her Majesty's sworn subject, the Prime Minister John Key, to take note of our visit, 6th of May 2016. This visit completes the removal of all vestiges, authorities of governance, and lawmaking assumed by John Key and his parliamentary associates, the pretentious corporation purporting to be the country of New Zealand's government in concert with the constitutional monarchy. In lieu of Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, and as one subject's inability to recognise our founding document and flag, the Rangatira people have taken the unprecedented step of serving Her Majesty notice to quit all Crown business. And rejection acts under 2002 of the practice of her laws in our land. In particular, the Crown business this relates to is the unilaterally imposed current governance structure, laws, and all instruments that support it. These above actions advised Her Majesty in the 2004 Sovereign Authority Orders will give her the statement of confidence she requested 2009 from her sworn subject, the Prime Minister John Key. Further, to the notice to provide full support and assistance to te waka o Mokopuna ki Aotearoa in the peaceful return of our country to its rightful heirs and authority. That's only part of it. But that is what's going to go out, and we'd love you to support it. If you're not able to, we accept it. But it will be natural. Kia ora tātou. Love you all.
Our time thing doesn't sit well with me, but you've got 15 minutes each.
And that'll give us a probably about 15 minutes just to have a little bit of a whakaaro before lunch, and ka hoki mai pēnā kāre kāre mō kia hoti te kaupapa. A moi mai tātou, e hara, e ko, ko ene o ngā kōrero hai poi poi te hinenga, are me whakatinga nā ki ngā kaupapa. Are I konei ki te whakatau, a nei mō ngā kaupapa. E whakaara kaupapa hoki.
Ngāti Porou Tūturu, e iu, ko Porou Rangi te tangata. Ako, ko horu te tua. Ko Nai Tāne ki Rangi Tukia, te hau. Puri atu rā, nā Puhi, ko hau te tahe o ngā Taumata Kaumatua. Engari ko whakarunga rua te maunga. Utu kura te aki. Ko te hoki a ngā whakapau karakia te moana. Ko mā ngungu rā. Te maunga tuarua e haina tia te. Te tiriti. E nui a mātou tūpuna. Te whātakau mā rima. Ke haina e te rāra. Ko mātou nā tūpuna o ko tūpuna e nui atu. Te haina te tiriti. Te haina huki rā te whakapura. I te votu ne. Nō rira, hei te mihi kia rā. Ara, ko nā toki mātou. Tēnā koutou, te mātātua waka. Reo karangatanga kato. Tēnā koutou, nā tuakana, a toroa, a muriwai, a puhi oki. Tēnē ka huri atu rāhi te reo tuarua. Māro mahuki mai rā koutou i nā kupuru. Te humai ne ki a hau, mai ki taumata kaumatua nui o. Te māra mai rā koutou i te rituata. Te humai rea i toko tua hene a tangaere. A Julie tangaere. Morangi tukia, no tiki tiki. A. Kurua tōre. Tini nā pepa, engari, te tikanga, te tangata e pānui tēne kōrero o te e whakaputanga, e kore e kei kone, nā e ko tau mahahare, ko ko mai ki a hau māku e, e, māku e whānwe. Ko te ko tō māua tama tērā, e kore tai mai. Koeni hui mō nā rangatiri tahi. Speech delivered by Julie Tangaere, Director of Waitangi Tribunal, at the handover of YWAI 1040. Te paparahi o te raki, stage 1 report. Te ti marae, Waitangi Bay of Islands, Friday the 14th, 2014. Tēnā koutou katoa. Te whare e tū nei, tēnā koe. Te marae e takotā kene, tēnā koe. E nā mate kua whakuti, ko whitu rangitia. Mau mai, moe mai, hoki hoki. He a tātou te hungaora, he nā iwi, he nā reo, he nā mai. He nā kārangatanga maha, he nā koutou kani. Ata Māria koutou. My name is Julie Tangaere. I'm the director of the Waitangi Tribunal Unit, the organization which provides the administration support service that the tribunal requires to hear treaty claims. And it is there my honor and privilege to be here to speak to you. To acknowledge this day, a day of deep significance for the tribunal, for you, and for their, and for New Zealand as a whole. Nearly 175 years ago, here at the Te, there were two tupunas debated whether to sign the treaty for Waitangi, and so form a new relationship with the British Crown. Here and at Waimate and Maungu, during the month of February 1840, more than 100 rangatira took that step. Ever since those first signings, there has been discussion, debate, and controversy over the nature of the relationship that the signatories committed themselves to. Did they cede sovereignty? As the Crown intended, did they agree that Britain would make laws for them? What about them? If not, then what did they agree to? How about them? Whakaetanga? What authority was the kawana to that? And how would kawanatanga government exist along tino rapa tino tamu. Full independent. Chiefly authority. It is these questions that the Waitangi Tribunal has considered and has sought to answer in this report. E Whakaputanga e te treaty, declaration, and the treaty. As you know, it has been a long road to get to this point. The tribunal has to listen respectfully to all sides and weigh all parties carefully. And this was something it could not rush. Ore tae te whakat, nā e roto I tai rā, e roto I te tau. O mata mate o kia kata o tātou tūpō. Nā, e te tai atu I tēnei rā. And heard the kōrero that your tūpōro handed down to you about what they agreed to when they debated and signed the treaty. It heard what the treaty meant to the crown. It heard from linguists, historians, anthropologists, and other scholars. It considered the whole relationship between Britain and the Maori. In te reo, right from its beginning, when the endeavour first sailed into view in 1769. It considered a great depth. The debate that took place in February 1840 and the text of this treaty. The English text with its decision of sovereignty and guarantee of position, and the Māori text with the secession of kāwanatanga and his guarantee of tino rangatira tanga. It had to consider the two texts, but it did not have to decide that they were both of equal weight. Taumaha katoa ngā mea. Engari karite whakaaro tērā. Having done all of this, having weighed out all the evidence as carefully and as passionately as it would, as it could, here is what the tribunal has concluded. What that means is the Rangatira signed the treaty in February 1814 at Waitangi, Waimate, and Māngu did not cede their sovereignty to Britain. te ara. Te ara. Hare kia tātou, kia rātou. What that means, te wāma, they did not see the authority to make and enforce laws over their people or their territories. They did not agree to share power and authority with Britain. Tātoui. In particular, they agreed to the governor having authority to control British subjects in New Zealand and thereby keep the peace and protect Maori interests. They consented to the treaty on the basis that they and the governor were to be equals, with each having different roles and different spheres of influence. In sense, the governor was to be a rangatira for the Pākehā. The detail of how the relationship would work in practice, especially where the Maori and European populations intermingled, remain to be worked out, neither in the treaty nor in the oral debates was the relationship between Kaumatua and Rangatira spelt out. That detail remains to be negotiated and over time on a case by case basis. This is the first report. There were other aspects to the treaty agreement. Rangatira agreed to enter into land transactions with the Crown, and the Crown promised to investigate pre-treaty land transactions and to return any land that had not been properly acquired from Maori. The Rangatira appeared to have agreed that the Crown would protect it from foreign friends and repress them in international affairs. They wanted Britain as an ally, a great global power able to protect them in times of need, and make sure that their authority endured times in need. Ma te okatari nga tērā, pahara mai rātou i te. Te awhiri a tātou, times in need, ne? We knew that Britain in February 1840 wanted more, though the treaty it intended to acquire sovereignty. Overarching power to make law applying to all New Zealand, Maori and Pākehā. It was supposed to protect us. Next minute.
But
that is not what Hodgson and his agents told Rangatira. You all know what the text of the treaty says, that Maori would retain their tino rangatira tanga, their independence and full authority. Also in the debates, rangatira were told that they would retain their independence and that Hobson wanted only enough power to control British subjects and protect Maori interests. Nothing in the debates conveyed Britain's full intention that it would acquire sovereignty and to be able to make law applying to Maori as well as Pākehā. Nothing conveyed Britain's intention that the treaty would override and replace the Whakaputanga. That clear declaration of the rangatira, the kingitanga, te mana, te whenua, I roto I a Bay of Islands and the Hokianga Māori. Nō reira ke, ke kone nā kōrero e a toa tia I roto I koutou hine ngaro. Nā te atua tātou e manaaki I nā wākātua, e rauranga tira mā kute mihi atu me I kia tō. He nui nā kōrero ki roto I tēnei re tō koe, ka whakarongo hau ki te haukāinga, kia whakatāputo te wa kōrero. Kare mōheo tikana koutou e whānau mai koutou, koutou tūpuna o me tātou tūpuna hoki, ko rongo o kē tātou me nei kōrero. Ka koe te mita, te naue o tēnei, ko tēnei ripuata, na te tribunal. Koe nei o rātou kitenga, koe nei o rātou tiruhanga, mai o rātou mahi. Te roko, te kuta hoki, te ngō mai rā katoi, me o tātou rangatahi. O rātou nā rangatira mō a pōke, te kore tātou e whakakua, te hoatu tō tātou mana, I te tahi atu. I te rinsi, so, to our youth, to our mokopuna, o tāi te tō te rā kia mātou I nā kaumātou, koe a pērā tēnau tātou karau I noho mai. Kia koutou e mau tēne, kia tū rangatira tātou e mūtō tātou whenua. Kua reira, o te mātua tama o wei me tāpu me nā me nā pūn. Āre kā honu kā pirihiri tua hāna. Mā ngai te roto he tau te koma, ka hei ane I āhine e hāna.
Tūturu tūna, ai a me, ake me, ake. begin with that, just to ensure that my nervousness is now exposed. I've been sent here with some instruction, and if I can, I'll just written a bit of notes to help me get through this 20 minutes. And firstly, I just want to meet to our auntie over here. I remember the day that your porero was presented to the Kaumatua of Kaumatua and Ngati Porou Hapu in the Pita Apiata, big branches, Moai and all of them, and they had total to that, and I'm pleased to hear the follow-up and the follow-on from that. I was the little fellow in the corner that can remember when the video camera and I had a snotty nose.
You
said
and a moko.
So in saying that, I just want to try and set a theme as to why the Taumata are saying what they're saying and contradicting probably everything that's going to be said here today. But before I do that, ka tai mai te kaupo o te whare taku ngāpu. Nō reira, ka nui te mihi taku tuakana o te waka mātātua. If I can begin with the story of Maori just briefly, it's said in myth and legends that his last feat was to go into the ancestor Hinanui port, and it's said that that's where he ended his attributes. We're debating that because we believe that we've all been through it as young people, where my man said to me, well, you have your mother's eyes, and you have your father's chin. I believe the tuku iho of Maori actually he succeeded in that attribute of tuku iho, of himself being everlasting. And we're the example of that, just to cut that story very, very short. And if I can also, I need to express, just to get the word antithesis very clear. And correct me if I'm wrong, the fourth commandment delivered by God to Maori, to Moses, thou shalt not commit adultery. The question that I've asked the religious people, and I've advocated that my tūpuna hapita renata was a scribe for women, so I'm not complaining about religion. But I've asked for the answer to, was Mary committed to Joseph at the time she conceived and gave birth to the child called Jesus? There's a bridge of that, as far as the Taumata is concerned. And also the suggestion that I've experienced on one occasion where three different hahi were standing over the hole of my cousin, arguing who was going to send him to heaven. And his father pushed them all out of the way and said, I'm going to send him to Hinehu Tō. So it gave a clear description, indication that there is a heaven and there is a place for us. And it's sad to say that some of my ancestors are standing at the gate being judged. And some of them are being told to climb down the hole where they call the place hell. And some of them are allowed to come out. And I want to make that clear. And in some cases, Pākehā are sitting around their campfire with our tūpuna in Hinanui Port. There's a very significant mix-up happening there. Just trying to get a line so we can the antithesis about Jack and the Beanstalk. My daughter was sent home with a Duffy book. We all know the Duffy books. Our kids get prizes, Duffy books. And this particular day, she was sent home with the story Jack and the Beanstalk. We all know that story. And so I analysed it as a parent. And what I found was Jack's mother was on peat and crack. And all she had left was a cow. Everything else was gone. So she sent her son to the market to sell the last thing that she had. And he, knowing his mother was on crack and pee, disobeyed that order. So when he got those beans, he came home and he grew the beanstalk. And what happened was, in our mind, is that he trespassed on someone else's land. Mm-hmm. He committed home invasion. Mm-hmm. He stole taonga. Mm-hmm. And when the owner of those taonga tried to recover them, he committed murder. And the conclusion of the story, even with the antithesis attached to it, they lived happily ever after. There's a concern with all what we're doing, and I appreciate one of my colleagues recently engaged in decolonization. young as far as Te Tiki is concerned, where, what was the word they use, Uncle? Youth, young, we need guidance. At that time, we took on the mightiest military force on the planet, called the English, and we had four wars. And now we engaged in four wars. And the first war
that
was
gonna have a talk, but
at
Omaha. Like it now.
That war was for water, and we won that war. And the second war was at Napa, and that was for geothermal, and we won that war. Now, it's escaped my mind what they fought for at Ohiwai. It was very significant. And the last war they had was at Huapikapika, and that was for land. If you stand on the park or that place called Huapikapika, you see the entire territory that has been the Mokopuna, you know, around the whole. You see that entire territory from that little hill.
Did you come so you can see?
So that's significant because the fights that we're having have been done with the coup. So we don't, I'm just suggesting you don't need to do that. So what I have here, Matua, is several years ago the Taumata got together. Taumata came out from 1920, I'm going to say. They were labelled an aggressive, an arrogant group of people, if I can say it like that. And I apologise if that's exposed to some of my fault. If we use it all, pieces of paper here.
Jim, we got to didn't come.
They're Jim, an attempt to help the young people who have no help. Not to get a description or a translation of He Whakaputanga.
Stand up and kill the whole place. Then look at it.
In the year, they spent the entire, you remember, Archie, they spent 3 days, the 26th, the 27th, and the 28th, doing this. A lot of the elders. Inuwai was part of it from Hauraki. What's that, Kaumata? They used to sing those songs from the battalion. Machu, Matarewa, he was part of it. Auntie Del, I remember Auntie Del very well.
Lie low for now.
Now, if I can, without reading this, there's a suggestion that if we are learned Maori in the English language and the English structures of laws, consider looking at this like that. I'm not asking our elders to do that. And I'm considering if you understand structuring, and a lot of us do, understand structuring of government legislations and policies. In a nutshell, in my mind, and I don't understand it, I choose not to, they have things like sections and subsections and clauses, if I can say it like that. So what we have here that's being suggested is a section of the tui. Firstly, if I can, the Taumata have been very critical in the kupu of He Whakaputanga, not being a declaration. Auntie, I'm going to support your kōrero. In the birth of a child, it's being proclaimed He Whakaputanga. A child is being proclaimed. I'm just suggesting that, and I'm no linguistic in the deal. So it's very critical that if we go down the line of it's a declaration, we find ourselves in hot water. I'm going to say it like that. The kupu in the English is being the closest word in English. Is proclamation, and we can argue that later on, possibly. You'll give me a good argument for that, eh? That'll be good. So, the first responsibility in our mōtiatia is very, very disciplined and structured. We have found that this document is done the same way. It's done the same way. So, in saying that, just in a nutshell, and trying to squeeze 100 and 200 years of kōrero into 20 minutes. The first compliance, Kaumata, that's the first section of this piece of legislation, Kaumata. Ko ngā tino rangatira, you can't go there until you're Kaumata. You can't go to another article, nor any other government to be established on any estate of assembled. You can't go there until we've got Kaumata. These are the suggestions. These are some of the very, very bad mistakes we've made. If we go to Article 3, over the page, It's got a very, very clear process on how we're meant to act in accordance with making ture. The first compliance, I'm suggesting, just reading this, we're the hereditary chiefs. Firstly, you have to be hereditary. And you have to collectively agree. That's what it says to you. And then you have to meet. We're making the mistake of meeting at Waitangi as the Whakamininga. It says here, we meet in Runanga Congress. It's a big mistake, meeting as the Whakamininga at Waitangi. I'm just suggesting that. And it has to be at Waitangi. And more importantly, it has to be in the Ngahuru. Some of us are meeting on the 28th of October, outside of the Ngahuru. That's the Maramataka Kōrero in there. So we managed, the tūpuna managed to squeeze the Maramataka in there as a compliance. It's a significant compliance of, I'm just suggesting that all the gardens are, you know, done. It's time to frame some laws. But it's, I just want to hinge on this just for 1 second. You have to be the runanga, not the Whakamininga. The Whakamininga has no ability to frame laws. That's just what it says here. So these are compliances. And you can only meet as a runanga at Waitangi in the autumn to frame 4 sets of laws in 4 different areas. And you have to create them for admin of justice, peace and security, end lawlessness. We're all complying. We're all complying in what we're talking about and what we're doing. It's just been suggested by the Taumata, categorise your law under what it says here. File it in there. It's for your own mind. That's all. We've known a lot of documents going to the UN and falling on deaf ears. Why? Because they've been delivered, they've been made on the 28th of October. You're meeting as the Runanga, you're meeting at Waitangi, you're complying with all the things, but you're meeting on the 28th of October. They monitor this process. And the only time I can say, not just to try to provoke you to say, I did that, and you did it, is on the 6th of February, there was a full compliance. And what popped out of that was the Whakaputanga. So I just leave that in. So in saying that, given that it's a proclamation, at the beginning of the Ngāpui hearings, the Taumata met with Joe Williams, he was the judge then, and he turned up with a blank piece of paper and he said, Ngāpui, you write your laws, write your rules. And so the Taumata came up with Ngāpui Nūpuna and produced 4 articles to the tribunal. And the first article was in accordance with Muri Whenua, Diro Whenua atu Hoki Whenua Mai, simple as that. And the second article was, Te Whakaputanga me Te Treaty. That happened to be heard first. And the third article was, we want an independent tribunal, not the Waitangi Tribunal. The Waitangi Tribunal, as far as the Taumata is concerned, have no teeth. There's no disrespect to Rangatira. So in saying that, the fourth article, Alfred, if you're not happy with the first three and they haven't complied with the Whenua, leave it to our next generation. So the Taumata Kaumatua's only role in the Ngāpui hearing process is to put all of the information in. That's it. They're not engaging in any discussion of negotiation or settlement or anything like that. And they're hoping that by the 28th of October this year, all the information is in there. So Alfred and all the rest of us, if you have something you want to chuck in there to deal with it, because it's our responsibility after the 28th to deal with it, get it in there. Use a Y number, any Y number, left or 20 of them, just use a Y number. So I'm going to try and close with this aggressive comment. If we go proclamation, okay, stage one report made a big mistake. The Tupuna did not see sovereignty in 1840. Sovereignty is a critical word because it does not translate tino rangatiratanga. And tino rangatiratanga does not say sovereignty. So, if we did not see sovereignty, I've asked the question, it appears someone gave it to us. And it also appears we can sell it in a settlement. And it also appears someone can take it off us. That's the word sovereignty. That's what the stage one report is lining us up for. How much or we'll take it off you. Because someone gave it to us. I've asked the question, who gave us sovereignty? Can any of you come up and answer that? Who gave us the sovereignty we didn't see? The sovereignty has to be given by an allocator. It has to be given by somebody, by an allocator. Someone had to give it. And I assure you, King William didn't give it. And the Queen didn't give it. I assure you, they didn't give it. So what's being said here is in 1835, Ngā Tino Rangatira, Tino, were recognised as an allocator of sovereignty. And here's the controversial bit. Sorry, it's just been so long, I've seen you many times. In 1840, Ngā Tino Rangatira allocated sovereignty to an unknown race of people. So it's them that have sovereignty. Yeah. It's government. Our tupuna gave them sovereignty because if we look at their existence when they were here without sovereignty, what were they? Exactly. Drop-offs. You know, nothing. But they had no culture.
Makes
they
our
had
documents
no status,
look good.
They had nothing. They had nothing. I was given sovereignty when our kaikaranga yelled at me three times to get it. I've got a sovereignty right here today. Who gave it to me as Tino Rangatira with our manaaki? Just trying to provoke us to accept that we are allocators of sovereignty. Sovereignty's no good to us. Sovereignty's no good to us. It puts us in a position to have to negotiate with an assumed. So in saying that, what else do we Napui Speaks is the article that came out of the report that came out of the Taumata's response. Now, one more conclusion. Andrew Uren is the Crown Lawyer for the Napui hearings, Paparahi Wakaraki Tribunal hearings, and unfortunately, I've got it on video, and Auntie, a lot of us didn't hear him say it. We heard him say it and we jumped with joy. He stood up and he concluded his speech to us. He said, Napui, we don't disagree with anything you've said in Te Treaty Meke Whakaputanga Corridor, Stage 1. And while we were laughing and cheering, he said, but we saw it differently. And then he started dictating how we engaged in Stage 2.
Yeah.
He said, that's the Crown evidence. That's where you're going to get your story from. Yeah. Not from Tukuiho. That's what he said. You're going to get your evidence from our research office. They're having hell with the old man right now. Believe me. So in saying that, I know I've got another 15 minutes later on some good stuff.
Oh, that's what it was. They were saying lunchtime. That's what they were calling out for. Come for lunch. I'll just finish this off. Well, we're just at MATAATUA Marae in Whakatane. In Whakatane, here with Jaymie. She's just come along to the hui tea. Say hello.
Hello.
So,
lunchtime.
I had a good listen, and now we're going for lunch. We'll see you. The runaway? Did you come by yourself?
Yeah.
Oh, so.
I'm gonna go put the
windows
up.
Oh, okay. I'll see you in the after.
Oh, I'll wait.
So, yeah, we're just enjoying the day. It's beautiful outside. We'll go outside now. I just want to take a photo of the.
Did you come?
Oh,
it's
okay.
Supposed to rain this
morning. Oh, my feet are out that way. We go that way. Beautiful Marae, look. nice. You see the nice day outside. And I put my shoes on. Look at that. Beautiful. I'm enjoying myself today. I've got to go down to the Maya shortly. And to another hui on a land block. With the orchards, the new orchards on the land block, just by the shops, from the shops in Omaio on the corner. Yeah, so that's what our day looks like. See? Look. Beautiful. I'm just going to catch Jaymie. She's come to the hui with me. And we'll see you later. Today is Saturday.